And welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity, The White March, Part 2, Blind. I am the RPG chick. We are in Stalwart Village, where people are understandably a little panicked, ranging from, I'd say, very concerned to panicked. There's a army which wants to claim the nearby Durgan's Battery as their own. Which is here. The Iron Flail Fort. Okay. I'm not completely sure, but this might be new as well. So naturally they're worried that after they attack Durgan's Battery, they'll be next. They did send delegates over there, and the delegates haven't returned, so that's pretty worrisome as well. We're ready to talk to this Darien guy who's lived here all of 2 months and has already gotten pretty unpopular with the locals.
No problem.
Which is no problem for us. Notice the, even the undead skull thing has, well, frost breath coming out of his mouth, interestingly enough. Durien. How's business? Improved and getting better still. His ears twitch and his face breaks into a wide smile. Thanks to you and the White Forge, there is great demand for my wares. We are for sale. He has clothing and... anything else? Wait, I didn't want to actually take that. Can I put that back? Thank you. What do we have in the way of belts? Right. This heals us occasionally, which is very useful. Oh, right. Wait, that's... This is a ring. This is the belt. Okay, regeneration. Watchful presence. This auto heals him, which is nice. Eotin. So he has Sentinel's Girdle. Yeah, he has Broad Belt of Power. Mortal Protection, right. That grants her knockdown, which is helpful. Decrease critical hit damage. Plus 2 might and plus 2 resolve. Constitution plus 3. Alright, let's see what kind of belt this guy's selling. This might be new. Plus 5 accuracy when below 50% endurance. Plus 20 defense against disease and poison attacks. I'll read about it though. Why not? This belt bears the mark of Riona, a legendary adventurer who traveled Eora in search of wealth and fame. When she was young, she trained at a martial academy in Ozia, where she struggled at first. Many of her fellow students came from wealthy local families, but she was poor and foreign. But she was clever, and she practiced much. One day, her chief rival, the nephew of one of the Duke's belles, challenged her to a duel. Riona could not refuse and save face, so she accepted. When they had assembled in the arena, he offered to give her one piece of his armor before the fight began. He meant it as an insult to her skill, but when Riona asked for his belt, he realized his mistake. He gave her his belt, with his sheath rapier still attached to it, effectively disarming himself. Riona won the duel by default and kept the belt as a memento. You know, I would have said just she only asked for the belt. So I would have taken the rapier and its sheath and just given her the belt. I mean, that's pretty silly. I don't remember this. plus two perception. This stuff is like, I don't know. It's seems interesting, and it's got, you know, it's got some bonuses, but it doesn't seem. I like regeneration and stuff. Anything to get the hit points flowing, you know. Rufek's Watchful Cloak Mark II. Rufek was a bruiser and a follower of Whale. He was often hired as a courier or a bodyguard because of his size and strength. Yet he was a quiet man, and he developed a habit of walking with his head bowed in prayer. Because of this, would-be thieves frequently attempted to waylay him. But Rufek was blessed by the God of Secrets. With uncanny foresight, he dodged and parried these sudden attacks and slew his assailants, sewing their eyes into his cloak. Oh my god, he intended it as a warning, but others saw it as a challenge. Eventually, he discarded this cloak and wore a simpler, subtler garment in its place. The sight of a dark cloak with shimmering, shifting eyes became infamous among highwaymen and bandits. Yeah, I'm not gonna buy anything here. Well, there's more, actually. We certainly have enough. Okay, Major Endurance. We need some more of these. I'll take the lot. Major Recovery. Right, these are for hostile effects. We have some of that already. Major Regeneration. Minor, I'm not going to bother with. Primal Flame. Oh, these are ingredients, right? These all went here. It's down here because I'm still in the trade window. You know what? Let me get out of the trade window. two there, one there. One and one. Oh, wait, I forget. Yeah, I'm double clicking. Alright. Oh, wait, he has one. Who doesn't have one? Yeah. We're gonna be getting more. Is this the actual zone? The mines here? If you're looking for work, Ismay might have something for you. I swear there's something strange going on in the mines. People keep talking about hearing voices in the tunnels. Same superstitions we had about the battery. Good work at the battery. Guess we owe you our livelihoods. Been having some tough times in the mines. Nothing like the open air. Being in the tunnels too long can really take it out of you. Let me just take a peek in there. I think... I guess not. Well, let's not mess around here yet. We don't have a... I do want to... The only thing about the fast movement... Fresh coals lie at the bottom of the smelter. I don't like the way the other people run around so quickly. Tarfos. Run for mayor, they said. It's an easy job, they said. I should have stayed in the mines. He notices you approach, and his eyes widen. Theodas, what brings you back to Stalwart? You're always welcome here. He beams at you. How's Stalwart doing these days? We've rebuilt. The Western Palisade is fixed, and some fancy merchant set up shop where Katie's house used to be. He gestures at the temple. We've also got a proper temple to Abydon again. Never understood why the Ondrites stuck around Stalwart in the first place. I'm pretty busy, so unless there's something else. What's that about, a negotiation? There's a group of merchants from Defiance Bay interested in a trade agreement with Stalwart. Their representative, Nesta, is staying at the Greff's Rest. I've been avoiding her because I have zero experience with treaties and contracts and all that. I was a miner, not a diplomat. Good God, man. Maybe you should talk to her on my behalf. Or could talk to her on my behalf. He looks at you, hopefully. As mayor, I'll give you full authority to negotiate on Stalwart's behalf. These people didn't like me very much. Now, all of a sudden, I'm given full authority and they're thankful of me. Things change quickly, don't we? Well, that's what this Nesta is. What makes you think I'll do any better than you in a negotiation? You're the hero of Stalwart, the woman who reclaimed the White Forge. Of course you'd do better than me. I'll go talk to Nesta, then. Thank you. As I said earlier, you can find her in the Greff's Rest. Cool. Risk tolerance. Mayor Tarfos wants me to escort Nesta around Stalwart and help hammer out the terms for a trade agreement with Defiance Bay. Tarfos has no confidence in his own negotiation abilities, so he wants me to handle it instead. Nesta is waiting for me inside the Greff's Rest. I'll have to meet with her to start the trade negotiation. Ever thought of settling down here? Tarfos isn't a bad mayor, but I liked having Risen Guild in charge. You know the guy standing right in front of you, don't you? Some people have no tact. I heard there was work in Stalwart, but the locals don't seem to like us. You seen Kern? He looked upset. Alright. Let's go poking around. An army at the gates? Is Stalwart usually this bad? Well met. Things are better under Renan Guild. Well, this is Ista. We helped her before.
This is going to be fantastic. Just wait till they hear about this back home.
Yeah, we helped her with something. Something having to do with some cave or something like that. We took recordings or something like that of the rock. I forget. Anyway, some kind of geological survey. The Temple of Abydon. Yeah, let's. Maneha is right there, though. Let's talk to Maneha.
Huh. That's what I get for asking directions in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah, huh?
Say, I don't suppose you've seen any mysterious old buildings in the mountains lately, have you?
Cool. It's pretty cool looking. The Amawa wears an assortment of bangles, bands, cuffs, and chains as thick as armor. She watches you with a raised eyebrow and eyes gleaming with mirth. Do you mean Durgan's battery?
Wait. Aren't you the one who opened the gates? Much as folk here talk about it, you're probably good for a free drink at the inn.
Hey, I'm down.
I'm looking for the Abbey of the Fallen Moon. It's an obscure temple dedicated to Ondra.
Why are you looking for it?
I'm a gift bearer. My job is to gather tokens of things people want forgotten and surrender them to the Lady of Lament. Best place to do that is the Abbey of the Fallen Moon.
What kinds of tokens do you take?
Anything that represents a moment or a memory someone wishes to leave behind.
Interesting.
Well, love notes, awkward family heirlooms, bad poetry. The kinds of things you want to forget.
Really? I see.
I might be here a while. Half the villagers have never heard of the Abbey. And the ones that have, no one knows where it is. So I'm trying to think of this as an extended holiday. In a remote mining village that smells like fish.
I've got business in the region. We could travel together.
You won't regret it. I've got a lovely singing voice.
Do you now? Okay, new companion. From what I understand, this is our only new companion.
And the company's welcome.
She winks at Palagina. I'm keeping Palagina in the party. Tough. I don't want to get rid of the Devil of Karak. She's so awesome. Maybe we'll pick her up for another, you know, the latter part of the journey or something. I'm not sure. But yeah, I can't get rid of these four. He's awesome, and well, these two are awesome, and I love them, so I can't really. So.
If you say so.
Sorry. Nothing to say when I recruit you? New quest, The Burden of Memory. Maneha, I'm not sure how to pronounce that, a gift bearer of Ondra seeks a hidden abbey where Ondrites leave things to be forgotten. She's looking for the Abbey of the Fallen Moon, a secret Ondrite temple where Maneha has been ordered to dispose of several tokens. She's joined me in the hopes that we'll visit this place during our travels. I'm sure we'll check it out. We can talk to her.
I'm here.
She's here. What you got for me? She says. First, how do you pronounce your name? Tell me about yourself. Where to begin? I spent almost 10 years as a mercenary in Old Valia. Plenty of work there. She tilts her head up and starts counting items off on her fingers. After that, I fought with pirates in the Deadfire. Or for them, depending on who was paying. Did a short stint in the White That Wends, then roamed around the Living Lands, and finally joined the Gift Bearers in Ixamatil. Hope I pronounced that right. And here I am, she grins. Actually, I was asking about where you came from before your adventures. Not much to tell, she waves a hand and looks away quickly. Grew up in Rortai. Left when I was pretty young, and haven't been back since. Why not? Oh, you know, spent almost 20 years there. Change of scenery is good, right? She gives you a breezy smile, but it looks forced. Okay, there's more to this story. But I see. Better to look forward than back. That's what I always say. Why so much travel? Guess staying one place never much suited me. So you gave up soldiering, piracy, and adventuring to join Ondra's gift-bearers? She laughs. Still plenty of adventures, just different circumstances. I have questions about some of the lands you visited. I'm always up for war stories. What was Old Valia like? Grand. A skirmish every day and a feast at another Comte or Marqueso's keep every night. Those were good, carefree days. Tell me about the Deadfire Archipelago. Dangerous. You got pirates and sea monsters, and don't even get me started on the merchants. I had a good run there, but I got tired of trying to keep track of who had a knife pointed at my back. What were your experiences in the White That Wends? Short. That place is too cold for anything but leaving. What do you think about this cold place? I'm curious about the Living Lands. She laughs. Most folk are. Even after 10 years there, feels like I just saw the edges of the place. You can start the day in a desert and find yourself in the middle of the jungle by nightfall. Everything there is just a little wilder. Goes for the folk as well as the creatures. Part of me misses it still, but you wake up every day knowing it might be your last. I stayed lucky longer than anyone has a right to expect. That's all I wanted to know. Something else on your mind? Why did you become a gift bearer? I guess I like wandering and meeting new folks. I've never been good at staying in one place for long. She shrugs. How did you end up in Stalwart? The other gift bearers told me Stalwart was close to the Abbey, so they suggested I ask for directions in town. You mean the other gift bearers don't know where the Abbey is? Like I said, it's one of Ondra's most ancient temples, and her followers aren't really known for their records-keeping. You're not exactly dressed for the weather. Well, Iximitol's flat is patter. Or platter. So when the gift bearers told me Stalwart was way up in the mountains, I thought they were exaggerating. She shrugs. Anyway, I hate packing. I have questions about the Abbey of the Fallen Moon.
Me too.
She glances at her boots. Why are you looking for the Abbey?
I'm a gift bearer. My job is to gather tokens of things. The best place to do that is the Abbey of the Fallen Moon.
Heard this. What kinds of tokens do you take?
Anything that represents a moment or a memory. Love notes.
Gift bearers usually dispose of tokens in the sea. Why are you going to the Abbey?
Well, you throw some things into the sea, and maybe they wash up on shore one day.
Point taken.
But you want something really good and forgotten. You take it to the Abbey.
She nods. What do they do with the stuff? Set it on fire and then stomp on it? Adair stares at Durrance with a half-crazed look in his eyes, scratching his beard in contemplation. His smile broadens as he thinks. Oh, what little nugget of wisdom is Adair about to grant us with, or gift us with? Oh, he didn't say anything. Something's coming up. Something's brewing in his Adair's head there. So, what are you taking to the Abbey now?
The Abbey's all about forgetting. Wouldn't be much forgetting if I told you about it, would there?
She gives you a sly grin. With a high perception score, we see that her smile falters briefly. So there's a secret. These might be very well tied together. She doesn't want to tell us about, you know, her early days. And she doesn't want to tell us about what she has to give to the Abbey. So naturally, there's something in her past, probably a memento or two or more that she has with her, that she is not really up to sharing for whatever reason. Interesting, in any case. Get back here. The Abydonians took over Ondra's temple. Stalwart needs skilled smiths more than ever.
Sure.
Alright, guys. Let's check out the Temple of Abydon. Right. Maska.
Oh, come on! Stupid sword!
Having some trouble there? This smooth anvil hardly looks like it's seen use. This warped breastplate is still warm from the forge. Can't talk. Engram wants us to focus. Now she's talking. Maska says, okay, now you're just pissing me off. She slams her forge hammer down on the unfinished blade with a loud clang. Straighten out, damn you. Temper, Maska. The older priest, Engram, glares at Maska reproachfully. Sorry, master. It just slipped out. She takes a deep breath and releases it slowly. What's wrong with the sword? Where to begin? She gestures at the rapidly cooling lump of iron on her anvil. For one, I can't manage to shape the metal no matter how hard I try. Mr. Engram says, envision a sword. So I'm envisioning really, really hard. I think I'm ending up with a club. Maybe a mace, if I'm lucky. But no sword. If my work doesn't improve soon, they'll kick me out of the temple. Can't be a priest if you're not a proper smith. Unless you help me. Maska glances around. Go on. I snuck a peek at Master Engram's lore books and came across a ritual that can enchant a forge hammer to boost smithing skill. That's exactly the kind of edge I need. I've already completed the first part of the ritual, crafting the hammer. Unfortunately, the next two parts require travel to the Deerwood, and there's no way Master Engram will let me leave anytime soon. Isn't crafting using a magical forge hammer unethical? I'm not trying to show anyone up, I just want to appear competent. You know, buy myself time until I'm actually competent. I better get back to it before Mr. Ingram gets annoyed with me. Why did you decide to become an acolyte of Abydon? It's a family tradition, one I've managed to keep going. She glares around the unfinished sword on her anvil. Barely. I'll complete the forge hammer ritual for you. That's great! She hands you a forge hammer. That hammer actually turned out all right. The first place you'll need to go is the Shrine of Abydon in Crucible Keep. That's in the First Fires District in Defiance Bay. Damn, too bad. We just came from there. I've never been there myself. Just place the hammer at the shrine and it should get blessed. Or something. After that, you'll need to find the Shrine of Magrin in Magrin's Fork. It's not far from Defiance Bay. To the north of the city, I think. Do the same thing with the hammer at the shrine, then head back here. You're gonna owe me a pretty penny for all this. Maska, an acolyte at the Temple of Abydon in Stalwart Village, wants me to complete a ritual that will bless her forge hammer and boost her abilities as a smith. Her current skill level is quite poor, and she's afraid she'll be kicked out of the temple if she doesn't show improvement soon. She asked for my help with the ritual since she's unable to leave Stalwart. Bless the hammer at the Shrine of Abydon in Crucible Keep in First Fires. Bless the hammer at the Shrine of Abydon in the Keep. Hi there. I hope you're not having any trouble with that ritual. I'm still working on it because I haven't moved. Oh, good to hear. Well, I'm not going anywhere. Better get back to it, etc. I don't think Maska will ever be a good smith. Can I take this stuff? I think so. Anything up now, we'll save. Star Bony. Miller's drawing. This slightly singed piece of paper has a charcoal drawing on the front. Oh, cool. That's cute. I don't know why we want to take this, but I'll take it. It's a quest item. Ingram wants us to focus. Okay, speaking of Ingram, this we'll get in trouble for, I'm pretty sure.
I can do that. That's settled.
I can't go in there without sneaking, though. Well, at least I got experience points. Maybe I'll come back here another time. And everyone's asleep or something. This shrine to Abydon is smooth and shiny, as if it were made recently. Well, it probably has, because this stuff wasn't here before. Ingram nods at you and smiles in recognition. Ah, the kindler of the White Forge. We owe you a great debt for the industry and faith you've restored here. Welcome to the Temple of Abydon. I'm not gonna snitch on her. This used to be a temple to Ondra. He tilts his head to one side. Back when this was a dying, forgotten place. But the clerics who tended it left, as is customary of their goddess. The throngs who have since come to Stalwart sought a more practical deity. What do you do here? I lead this temple and guide the acolytes in matters both spiritual and mundane. He indicates the forge and anvils. Worshippers of other gods pray or meditate. We Abydonians venerate our god through the act of smithing. Our doors are always open, and our forge always alight. How may I help? Oh, by letting me leave. Farewell.
No problem.
Alright, what else do we have here? The fishery. Soon we're gonna have to call in an episode, I'm afraid. Star, it's changing. Can't expect the Lady of Lament to like it. You seen Kern? He looked upset. Pleasure to see you. Empty. Probably because I took stuff out of there already. Well, let's check out the fishery. Wengra won't get the battery's cannons working. They've been frozen solid for centuries. This tatter net appears to have been set aside for mending. The dead eyes of Speckleback, Irontooth Pike, and Frost Diver Fish gaze up at you. These roasting fish provide much of the pungent odor permeating the fishery. Okay. I'm pretty sure there's, like, nothing that... You know, it's probably, like, rice in there or something. Hunting party got stuck in a blizzard last week. Ondra's mad about her temple. One temple. What temple? It's to, Abydon now. Yeah, we've read that before. Anything else to see around here? Aska. What? She started saying something. A well-built dwarven woman stands before you, one hand on her head and the other holding a few sheets of paper. Three complaints of blights in Whitestone Hollow. And who are these people? Magwin's faithful? Great. Another pack of religious zealots. It's like they're popping up out of the snow these days. She glances up at you. Oh, sorry, Theodess. Just a little preoccupied. Things may have quieted down with some with the ogres lately, but there's been no shortage of new trouble. Or work, for those interested. Just saying. You mentioned blights? The terror of Whitestone Hollow. It's a grand blight that turned up after the avalanche. Real disaster, that. A great big heap of snow right on top one of our main trade routes. We can't start fixing the roads until we get the blights out of there. Can't exactly ask you to bring this back this thing's head, but word is the Terra's last victim was a caravan master. Turns out the fellow always wore a certain brooch. Figure it's somewhere in that monstrosity's belly. Bring me the brooch and I'll take it as proof that you handled the blight. Sound fair? I don't have a way to say yes or no. Who are Magrin's faithful? Bandits and horse thieves, far as I can tell. Led by a woman named Roadwith? Problem is their little group keeps growing, and they've started tearing through some of the smaller villages. They were last spotted by Searing Falls, and rumor is they're headed in our direction. Starwood's just getting its bearings. We can't afford this kind of trouble. Bring me Roadwith's head, and I'll see you a little richer for it. Okay. Oh, these are bounties. Okay. A recent avalanche killed dozens of travelers and tradesmen on the road to Whitestone Hollow. Their souls formed a blight that now haunts the countryside. Well, that's horrible. Aska believes the caravan master's distinctive brooch is frozen inside the blight. After I kill the creature, I can retrieve this brooch to claim my reward. And brigands calling themselves Magrin's Faithful have been pillaging small towns throughout Deerwood. Given Stalwart's recent influx of wealth, they worry they may be the band's next target. Kill Roadwith at Searing Falls and take her head. Magrin's Faithful have been headed north and were last seen at Searing Falls. They're led by a woman named Roadwith. That's a stupid name. I hear some of these newcomers are Iron Flail spies. The Abydonians took over Ondra's temple. Stalwart needs skilled smiths more than ever. Oh, this is a nothing thing. Herman's Emporium. Herman's Emporium. Alright, so stay tuned next episode when we go inside Herman's Emporium. Maybe we'll finish up all this stuff. We need to go to Thirsk's house, the Greff's Rest, sorry, Renningild's house, Tana's house, and Hammond's Emporium. Thanks for watching, see you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.